said.
Do you think I'm an athlete?
What are you talking about?
Well, you know, I think I'm an athlete, and sometimes I feel like you guys don't see me that way.
As someone who's never dated men in my entire life, sometimes my girlfriend will say something as someone who has dated a man, and it just completely blows my mind. And today we had one of those conversations where essentially she was talking about how, compared to her relationships with men, our relationship is different in the fact that she doesn't have to sacrifice a lot of the girly things that she really likes to do. For example, this compilation of videos is when me and my girlfriend just went shopping to go see all of the Valentine's themed stuff at a complex near us. We didn't particularly need anything, we just wanted to kill some time and hang out together, so we literally went and like window shopped for a few hours. And she told me that she never would have done this with her boyfriends because they never really liked shopping. They didn't like window shopping, even though it brings her so much joy. And it brings me joy too. It's one of our shared interests. Anyway, it just made me really grateful because I've never really had to sacrifice any of my girly interests because I've never had to date a man. I've never had to sit through a football game I didn't want to watch. I've never been forced to watch somebody play video games. And I honestly feel like this is just such an underrated privilege of being a lesbian. I'm grateful for my sexuality for a lot of reasons, but I just thought this was a cute, small, little fun one that I'd share with you so that you can enjoy it in your life too.
Can we fast forward to go down on me? Stop there and let me correct it. I wanna live a life from a new perspective. Come along because I love your face, and I'll admire your expensive taste. And who cares divine intervention? I wanna be praised from a new perspective. But leaving now would be a good idea. So catch me up on getting out of here.
To be a black queer woman, like, to be all of those things at one time is so lit because we are literally walking symbols of everything that society is against, and we're still here. But the caveat to that is that to get here, the work that we have to put in just to show up as our authentic selves is wild. Like, the amount of identity work that I have done over the years, the mental, emotional, spiritual work, from the therapy sessions to the books I've read to fasting, prayer, you name it, just so that I can defend my identity and to feel at peace with who I am and show up in the world with confidence is wild. The fact that I even had to do that is just crazy to me. And I really pray that the generations after us do not have to deal with this. That their identities, their queerness, their blackness, all of that together is not up for debate. Period.
Hi, I am looking for my daughter, Christy.
There is no Christy here. You have the wrong house.
Who is that?
Some lady looking for some girl named Christy, but, you know, there's no Christy here. Was the woman, like, this tall, blue eyes?
Yeah.
That was my mother. Why is your mother looking for a girl named Christy? She still calls me Christy. That makes no sense, and that is why I told her there is no Christy here.
You are truly a good and thoughtful friend.
What?
It's just so great that you're so accepting of me being trans and me changing my name.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Give me a hug, pal.
No, thank you. No, I genuinely forgot that you were trans and what your birth name was, so Thank you, but no thank you, not necessary.
We're lesbians. We met each other 2,237 miles away.
We're lesbians. Of course we U-hauled after 2 months.
We're lesbians. We're Bluetooth synced.
We're lesbians. At least one of us cries after every argument.
We're lesbians. Of course we saved a German Shepherd from the shelter.
We're lesbians.
Hi, Benji here, and this is why I'm trying to stop using the phrase identifies as. As a queer person, I've always used this phrase to express my gender and sexual orientation and describe that of others. But someone recently kindly pointed out to me how that phrase can be invalidating, and it does make sense. To identify is to establish what or who something or someone is. And self-identification of gender and sexual orientation is important. Everyone deserves the right to define this aspect of their identity for themselves. And by saying I identify as queer, I'm reflecting my journey of self-identification. However, when I say who I am, I don't necessarily have to reflect that journey. I can just say that I'm queer because I am. And when we describe people who aren't cishet as identifying as, it can sometimes imply that their identity is temporal or up for debate. Especially as people don't typically describe the identity of cishet people the same way in casual conversation. They just say who they are. There will still be times when it's necessary and important for me to describe who I am in a way that reflects my journey of self-identification. And if someone describes themselves using that phrase, I think it's inclusive to respect that. But unless it's necessary, I'm going to try my best to steer away from identifies as to just say is. You may want to consider doing the same. Hope that helps. Bye.
Yeah, so my girlfriend and I... There are people nearby. Don't you mean your traveling companion or your fellow spinster?
Oh, no, it's okay. I'm kind of in a place where it's accepted for me to have a girlfriend.
What? Have I died? Are we in heaven or hell?
No, you didn't die. You're in the future. I live in California. It's pretty liberal here. I have a girlfriend and we go out in public and we can hold hands and kiss and for the most part, not get harassed.
Oh, so there is some harassment still. You've been tarred, feathered, burnt at the stake, or attempted. I mean, even I've had my fair share of tying ups on the pole, but small wrists I always wiggle out.
Oh, no. No tarring, no feathering, no burning at the stake. It's usually like me and my girlfriend kiss, and then some guy at the gay bar comes up, and he's like, hey, you're looking for a third? And we're like, why are you even in a gay bar? You're literally a straight man. And he's like, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, yes, that's actually worse. I think I might prefer being burnt.
And I froze. I sat there with my mouth open, not knowing what to say because...
Today is day 1,988 of being a guy. Like, I was born, doctors were like, that's a girl. As I was growing up, I was realizing, huh, this maybe isn't for me. And in 2018, 1,988 days ago, I got my first binder, which is basically like a super tight sports bra that compresses your chest so you look flat-chested. Since then, I've been on hormones for 3 years. I got top surgery like a year and a half ago, and I'm very happy, but at the same time, I see so much transphobia in this world, and I feel like a lot of this transphobia is just rooted in misunderstanding. I often get comments like, so girls are trying to be men now? I thought only men wanted to be women. We've been around for a damn long time, and trans men, especially trans men of color, we're very forgotten about in the LGBT community and in society in general. So I'm hoping maybe a little bit more visibility for trans men, like, hey, I'm trans and I'm cool and I'm just a guy, could be beneficial to our community. So hi, I'm Gino Mateo, or Gadeo for short, and I'm a trans man, and I'm here to stay, and I'm happy.